हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे हरे।
Thank you. Thank you, Ramchandra, for leading. Thank you so much. Who wants to say the sloka?
Without seeing. Samskruti?
Yes, without seeing. Okay, Samskruti?
The first one or the second one?
First one. Go ahead for the first one.
तेषां सततयुक्तानां भजतां प्रीतिपूर्वकं ददामि बुद्धियोगं तं येन माम् उपयन्ति ते.
Thank you, Samskruti. Now Mataji is there. Mataji will take over.
Thank you, Vinita Gandharvika Mataji. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, Mataji, you are audible.
Oh, okay. Even you are audible.
Yes, Mataji, we can hear you.
Oh, thank you, Mukund. Okay, go ahead. Who wants to say the next shloka?
Ramachandra.
Nami Balram.
Can Subhadra go?
Ramachandra, Mukund, then Subhadra.
Okay. Tesha meva nukham partha maha magnana jamtama nashayam yatma bhavasto gnana deepena bhashvata.
Ramachandra, can you switch on your video, please? All the kids, whoever can switch on, please switch on. But if somebody else is eating or busy, then that's fine. But it will be very nice to see your faces. Okay, next, whom did I say?
Me, Balram.
Yes, Balram.
Tesha meva nukham partha maha magnana jamtama nashayamyatma bhavasto gnana deepena bhasvata.
Who wants to say next? Any of you?
Mataji, you said Mukund can go.
Haan, Mukund, go ahead.
Yes, Mataji. Tesha meva nukham partha maha magnana jamtama nashayamyatma bhavasto gnana deepena bhasvata. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Mataji, can go?
Who is that?
Subhadra.
Haan, Subhadra, go ahead. You know that Tesha I always ask you to...
Tesha mevanu kampatam aham magyana jantama nashayam yatma bhavasto jnana dipena bhashvata. To show them special mercy, I dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance.
That's very nice, Subhadra. See, every time I ask you to read the translation, right? Subhadra only read today, because if you say translation, then you will remember what you are saying. Who is it? I am 16. Is that your sister, Janavi? Your sister is already 16?
Janavi is 16.
Janavi is 16. Okay, Janavi is 61, not 16. January 61, right, January? By mistake, you wrote 16, right? Okay, next, who wants to say?
Hare Krishna, Mataji, can Prathamesh go?
Yes, Prathamesh.
Mataji, this 10.11 shloka.
Oh, okay. Which one? You want 10? Go ahead.
तेषामेव अनुकम्पार्थम् अहम् अज्ञानजं तमः नाशयामि आत्मभावस्तो ज्ञानदीपेन भास्वत.
Translation.
To show them special mercy, I, dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance. Thank you, Mataji.
Is there anybody else who wants to try this shloka?
Mataji, can I try?
Mataji, can Parikshit go?
Yes, Parikshit. Go ahead.
Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam tadami buddhi yogam tam yena mamupayantite.
Translation.
To those who are constantly devoted to serving me with love, I give the understanding by which they can come to me.
Thank you. You want to say the next
Mataji,
one?
Mataji, can Samskriti say 10.11?
Yes, Samskriti, there are a few kids who didn't get one chance also. Let me go to them and then come back to you, okay?
Okay, Mataji.
Krishnanayana.
तेषामेवानुकम्पार्थम् अहम् अज्ञानजं तमः नाशयामात्मभावस्तो ज्ञानदीपेन पाश्वतः. To show them special mercy, I, dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance.
Very good. Ojasvi?
Mataji, yes, can Varun do after Ojasvi?
I was looking for you, Varun. Yes, after Ojasvi you can do. Okay, Ojasvi.
Teshamevanukampatam aham ajnanajam tamaha nashayam atma bhavasto jnana deepena bhashvata.
Translation.
To show them special mercy, I dwelling in their hearts, destroyed with the shining lamp of knowledge and a darkness born of ignorance.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Varun, go ahead.
Okay. Teshamevanukampartam aham ajnanajam tamah nasayasyasma bhavasto jnana deepena bhasvata. To show them special mercy, I dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance.
Very nice. Prahlad, you want to say? Okay, Prahlad is talking to his mama. Is there anybody else who wanted to try and didn't get a chance? Sri Krishna. Balram didn't get
it.
Oh, very nice. Vrinda, if Janavi is 16, then what are you? You're also 16?
Yes, Mataji.
No, you're
16.
Because
I'm 6. So I'm also
61. So you are also 60.
January
is 61,
you are 60. You know I'm 61. Like
no. January. No. Vrinda is the Dadi of the group. Okay. I'm just teasing you, okay? It's okay. Where are you? Show me your face. Okay, I was just teasing you, okay? Okay. See, 60-year-old lady is dancing. Huh? Okay. So, who wants to try? Is there anybody else?
Mataji.
Hey, Nandini, Mataji.
Yes, Nandini, go ahead.
Tesham evanukampartam aham agnyanajam tama nashayamya atma bhavastha jnana deepena bhashvata.
Okay. Who else?
Can Raya Prahlad go?
Anandini, translation.
To show them special mercy, I, dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance.
Yes. Oh, good. Prahlad?
You took Jana?
Prahlad wanted to say that. He was asked. Where are you?
Teshamevan kampartam aham ajnana jamtamaha nashayamya ma bhavasto jnana deepena pashvata.
Very nice.
To show them special mercy, I dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born in ignorance.
Very, very good. So all of you got a chance, right? So can we go for today's discussion? Or is there anybody else? Oh, Samskriti, you wanted to try this, right? Go ahead.
तेषामेवानु कंपार्थम अहम् अज्ञानजं तमा नाशयामि आत्मभावस्तो ज्ञानदीपेन बाष्पता. Translation: to show them special mercy, I, dwelling in their hearts, destroy the shining lamp of knowledge, the darkness born of ignorance.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. Very good.
Mataji, Sri Krishna didn't get a chance.
But he's not talking. Sri Krishna, I was calling him. He's not
responding. Yes, Mataji. I have my hand raised up.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. तेषामेवानुकं पार्थम् अहम् अज्ञानजं तमः नाशयामि आत्मभावस्तो ज्ञानदीपेन बाष्पता.
Translation:
to show them special mercy, I, dwelling in their hearts, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance.
Very good. Kushi Agarwal, you want to try? I don't think she's there. Okay. Okay, then if all of you are done, then we will start our today's discussion. So where did, what did, can somebody say just one or two lines? What was the discussion of yesterday's? Who wants to go? Please raise your hand.
Mataji, I wasn't here yesterday.
Who was there can tell?
I don't know.
Ramchandra. Ramchandra always tells me. Ramchandra is there?
Yes, Mataji.
So what happened in yesterday's discussion?
I forgot.
You forgot? Parikshit was there?
I forgot, Mataji.
Okay. So did Yashoda Maya tie Krishna or not?
Yes,
on the latest was where Balram came and then
Suraj is telling me. Suraj.
Okay, that's what I think.
So in the last class you said that
not I. Yesterday's class, Sita Priti Mataji took, right? So I was asking where did you end?
We ended at when Balram could not help and Balram went away.
Okay, so we ended at Krishna is tied, right? You all are, remember that Krishna has been tied now. Last week we were discussing that Yashoda Maya was, last week also, yeah, she tied. She was trying to tie and she tied, right? So now let's see today we'll discuss more stories. Okay, so we have half an hour time and towards the end, we just have a very small, very simple craft today, not craft, drawing, very simple. So for the last 5 minutes, we will see that and we will see how many pastimes we can cover. Okay. So by the way, how are your holidays going?
Good, Martha.
Good. Okay. So last week, if you remember in my session that we discussed on Tuesday, we have discussed about Mother Yashoda being very protective. That was one of the reasons why she tied Krishna, because Krishna was saying that I will go to forest and stay with the monkeys. She didn't want Krishna to do that. So we discussed that Mother Yashoda has been very, very protective. That's the reason why she tied Krishna to the mortar. Okay, and she also wanted to discipline him. That was one of the reasons too. And we discussed various scenarios where our parents will discipline us. So do you all agree with me now that mothers are protective? Not just Mother Yashoda, because of course, what all we have in here is coming from the spiritual world. So she's the mother there. So definitely, yes, you all agree that mothers are being protective. So yes. Do you think only the mothers of human beings are protective, or all the species mothers are protective?
All the species.
Okay. So can you tell me, I'll pick two of you. You have to tell me a few scenarios how your mother will try to protect you. Okay. So we will give chance to Prahlad. Prahlad, can you tell a scenario or a situation where your mother tries to protect you? Anything. It could be small or big. Oh, Prahlad is not talking. Why nobody? Oh, Prathmesh.
Yeah, Mataji. So one time, like when my father gets angry, my mother like just comes in and says it's okay.
I know mothers do that a lot. Yes, so we will go to Parikshit.
Mataji, what did Prathmesh say? My system just cut down phones.
Prathmesh said many when his father gets angry at him, his mom immediately goes and says it's okay.
Same.
I do that a lot. I do that a lot too.
That also happens to me, except when my mom does that, my grandma does it. My grandma like does the same thing.
Yeah.
If I'm at my grandma's house.
For me, it's the other way around. My father mostly protects me.
Yeah.
Okay, now we'll see. Parikshit, can you say how anything, like, it's not just from scolding perspective and disciplining perspective, it could be anything, any incident where your mom tried to protect you. Parikshit?
Like, where there's a lot, when we're in a large grouping like Disney World, she's protective so that I don't get lost.
Oh, okay. Varun Kasturi is busy eating.
Yum, yum, yum.
Okay.
Can I show an example?
Yes, who is that?
Yes, Mukund Mataji.
Yes, Mukund. You know, I wanted to ask you, but last time you said something we asked and Mukund said, I never did any pranks, Mataji. So I thought he'll be quiet today. Yes, Mukund, go ahead, say.
In the New York theater, because there's so much population, my mother had used her dupatta and tied my hand so that I won't get lost around.
Wow, that's a very good tip. Okay. So, anyway, so we are all accepting and agreeing that. Oh, Krishnanayana wants to say something. Yes, Krishnanayana.
Like when I'm somewhere, like in the airport or something, my dad or mom holds my hand so I don't get lost, like how I got lost when I was in Tampa.
Okay. You know, see, it need protection. See, mother can protect you when you're sick. Mother starts protecting you when you're in the womb. So mothers, in general, parents are very protective, but mother is kind of overprotective, right? Mostly I'm talking. See, some mothers, as Ramachandra was saying, it's mostly my dad. Some mothers might seem to be strict, but they're internally not strict. So, how many mothers do we have in total, like according to Shastras?
I think
7 mothers.
7.
Our own mother, Earth, and
cow, doctors,
the cow, nurses,
yeah,
doctors, the wife, Ramana. And the wife of the guru.
The wife of the guru.
So this is the shloka from what Chanakya Pandit has written. Mukund, can you say this? Can you recite this shloka, Mukund?
Yes, Mataji. Atma Mata Guru Patni Brahmani Rajapatnika Dehur Dhriti Dhati Dhatri Tatha Prithvi Sapaita Matara Smritaha.
Okay. Ojasvi, can you read the translation? Ojasvi is there?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, translation.
One's own mother, the wife of the guru, the wife of the brahmana, the wife of a king, the cow, the nurse, and the earth are known as the 7 mothers of man.
Okay. So do you think only our own mother is protecting, or do you think all the mothers listed can play a role in protecting us? Yes or no?
All the mothers.
All the mothers.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, right? So the real mother, of course, she has the highest percentage, you know, of protecting any child, like, you know, highest responsibility, highest love. So she takes all the major percentage. So now, how the wife of a teacher or a spiritual master can protect us? Anybody has an answer?
I do, Mataji.
Who is that?
My name is Sri Krishna.
Yes, Sri Krishna, go ahead.
For example, Prabhupada, he gave us, like, he teach us, like he translated Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, etc., so we can read and get knowledge.
No, you're talking about wife of a teacher or spiritual master. So who has an example? If somebody can think of an example of a wife of a spiritual master or teacher in any history that you have read, can somebody think of any example?
Wife?
Subhadra. Subhadra, yeah. Can you think of any example?
Not a book distribution to please him.
I know one.
Wait, Krishna's teacher and his Krishna teachers and his wife.
Mataji, why
Okay. You all have to remember Sandipani Muni's ashram when Krishna went, Subhadra was mentioning what will she do when Krishna and Balaram were going. She will give some chickpeas, right? She will think, oh, they might feel hungry and she will give chickpeas. Do you remember that pastime?
Yes. Mataji, can Ramachandra say one more example?
Yes. We have to be a little quick because we have more to discuss in less time.
So when Sita, Mother Sita was in the forest, I forgot the muni's name, but when they're like in the Dandakarya forest, they met one sage and the wife of the sage was like giving like ornaments and all that.
Okay. So even you can see Janava Devi. Janava Mata, the wife, the consort of Nityananda Prabhu, after Nityananda Prabhu left, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left, she actually took care of the whole spiritual mission of our ISKCON. I mean, our Sampradaya. She has actually been leading. So that's how she protected. If she was not there, then she nourished the Goswamis. She took care of everything. So then... who is the, whom you can think the wife of a king? Example of wife of a king. She's a very famous example. Very, very famous Sita queen.
Dhruva Maharaj's mom.
Who said that?
Samskruti.
Yeah, Dhruva Maharaj's mom is also one example. And Queen Kunti. Queen Kunti, how nicely she protected her kids when her husband
Sita. Left.
And I am looking for one more Sumiti. Example.
Mother Sita.
Okay, I'm looking for one more famous example. If Parikshit is there, his name only, actually, if from his name,
Uttara.
We can say who.
Uttara.
Mother Uttara was trying to protect her baby. She started Uttara. Saying, Pahi, Pahi, who knows the shloka? Pahi, Pahi, Mahayogim. Right? She started saying that shloka. She was running for protection. Right. And the wife of a Brahmana. What example do you get reminded?
Wife of...
I don't remember the past tense name, but the time when Krishna and the cowherd boys were feeling hungry and they went to the Brahmanas.
Yes, the Yajna Patnis. Yes.
What about
Brahmana? Okay. So now we are seeing about... See, we know nurse, the nurse's position is also high because when you are all small kids, the nurse can take care. You know, we need nurse when you're old, you might see some grandparents or if you're really sick, you're bedridden, then the nurse serves you, right? So that is there. And Mother Earth, we have seen in the past, like how Mother Earth was trying to protect all the creatures on because all the demons were trying to, harm Mother Earth. And Mother Earth is the one who goes and, Mother Earth cries, right, to Lord Brahma. So Mother Earth is protective. And the cow.
Gomata.
Gomata, not just giving milk. I will tell you one pastime. There is one lady called, it's actually a very, very deep and very emotional pastime. But you know how cows can protect us? Cows, the animals also have feelings. In Kali Yuga, sometimes then if we see some situations, at least the animals attack whom they're supposed to eat, but not, and once the animals eat, they're satisfied. But now in Kali Yuga, if you see, the humans are not at all satisfied. They are more and more and more hungry for many things. So, I'll tell you this pastime. Yes. What happened was, there is one lady called Sindhu Thai. Okay, she's still alive. So, what happened, we'll quickly and briefly see. Anybody of you know about her? Just raise your hand.
No, Mataji.
Yes, Parikshit is saying he knows. So we'll see. So what happened? This Sindhu Thai, she had two kids already, two or three kids, and she was having a baby. She was having a baby in her stomach, and that time the collector is like a government official who is in a high cadre. So he was, he was actually mistreating. He was doing some illegal things. So the Sindhu Thai, there was one person who was doing something bad, and the Sindhu Thai, she was, everybody was hesitating to complain, but the Sindhu Thai went and complained to an official saying that this man is troubling. So this man developed vengeance and grudge on her, and she started tangling lies about her to her husband. And finally, for whatever reasons, her husband had to kick her out of the house. And she didn't know where she had to go, and she was just lying in the cow shed, unconscious, because she was so stressed out. She was lying in unconscious state. And the cows, a few cows were trying to stamp her, walk around her, but there was one cow which came and started protecting her. The cow started taking care of the her, because she was unconscious. And actually she had the small baby also with her, because she had a baby in her womb, right? So the baby was also born, and the baby was also there. And then, see, the cow only protected her. This is a very big story. Later again, now she's taking this Sindhu Thai. The cow took care of her. The cow protected her from being, more harmed by the other cows and bulls. Then later she took this small baby, and she struggled a lot to raise her. But somehow she got a lot of inspiration from Krishna that now she has an orphanage, and she's taking care of thousands of kids who don't have their mother and father. So the point I wanted to mention here is even cows can protect you that way, not just giving milk, because they have a lot of emotions. They have lots of feelings. So animals can understand our emotions. Okay. So that's about mothers being protective. All this we had to discuss because Mother Yashoda was very, very protective about Krishna. That's the reason she tied him. So now, next, what happened? I just mentioned, okay, these are different pictures. She's Draupadi. See how Draupadi also was so motherly. She didn't want Bhishma to kill Ashwatthama. Though Ashwatthama killed all her sons, she was saying, it's okay, forgive. I don't want his mother to feel bad. So that was happening. And so now what happened? Yashoda left Krishna. And she thought, okay, now I'm tying him. So she didn't, because Yashoda Maya always thinks Krishna is a very small baby. She couldn't explain. We last time discussed so many pastimes, right? About how Yashoda Maya forgets that Krishna is a supreme personality of Godhead. So then what happened was Yashoda Maya tied him, and she went with her gopis to do all the, to do all the pastimes. Sit here. Wow. Careful. Give me a minute. Just give me a second. I'm so sorry.
It's okay, Mataji.
That's okay, Mataji.
Really okay.
Mataji.
Usually got friends over, one of them got hurt.
I'm thinking she's having a really long conversation.
All right. So what?
Yeah, okay. So then, I'm so sorry. I am in my friend's house and there are a lot of kids. So anyways. So then she tied Krishna. And what happened? She went to do her chores with other gopis, and she thought, okay, now since that I tied him, Krishna is not going to go anywhere. See how innocent Yashoda Maya was. She was underestimating Krishna, right? Like then what did she do? She called the friends and she said, okay, you sit here, God Krishna, you just sit here. You think Krishna's naughtiness came down after that?
No.
You think Krishna thought it's okay, or my mother tied? You think it happened?
No,
right? Krishna, then what happened? Krishna was externally crying, but still he was so naughty. What he was doing with that grinding motor, still he started crawling everywhere. And his glance fell on two Yamala Arjuna trees. And then he has kept on crawling, like you see in the picture, he has been crawling. And then he could have very well asked his friends to untie him, right? Friends could have done that. But he didn't even do that. And in fact, he was telling to his friends, hey, look, the doors are open in that gopi's house. Why don't you just go and steal butter? Still he's naughty. Mother Yashoda tried to discipline him, but still he's naughty. And he's saying, steal more butter. And he kept on, crawling around with that grinding mortar. And now comes the question, why Krishna didn't ask his friends to untie him? He could have done that, right? How many of you would have done that if your mother would have tied you?
Me.
I would
have done with COVID, but normally, yes.
I would have.
Yeah, but why do you think that Krishna didn't ask that? Why? We discussed this point because he was feeling so much comfort. He was feeling so much sheltered. He didn't think that as rope. He saw it as love of Mother Yashoda. And we have discussed that was the reason Mother Yashoda also could bind him. So now we will discuss some pastimes. Okay. So we came to an understanding that with love, we can bind Krishna. We have seen two different pastimes in the last week discussion. So now let's see a few scenarios. There are so many, but few we will discuss today to see where Krishna, he just wants love from the devotees. He will do anything. Krishna can do anything. Krishna will lie for a devotee. Krishna will steal for his devotees. Krishna cares for his devotees. Krishna even changes his gender for his devotees. Krishna will do a lot of planning for his devotees. Krishna will do all the work. So we will take few examples and we'll see few pastimes. Okay. So who is this?
Shanidev.
Yeah.
Shanidev.
Yes. So what happens? Yes. So one time Krishna's birthday was being arranged and everybody wants to see Krishna's birthday, right? So a lot of guests were there and Shanidev also had a desire. Shanidev thought, I also have to see Krishna. But as he was entering, Yananda Maharaj saw and he asked, who are you? And he explained that he's Shanidev. Then Nanda Maharaj said, oh, Shanidev, if you come now, all the guests will leave because everybody is scared of you. Can you please leave? If somebody says that to you when you go for a birthday party, what will you do?
I'll be very disappointed.
Yeah.
I'll say bye.
So Shanidev is also so disappointed and even sadly. But Krishna loves his devotees, right? The demigods are the devotees of Krishna. So Krishna thought, how can I keep Shanidev sad? So he wanted to say a lie. He was saying to Yashoda Maya that, Maya, I was getting so bad dreams yesterday night in my dreams. I'm getting so scared of those dreams. Can you please take me to Shanidev temple? Actually, in Vrindavan, there is a place called Kokilavan. And in Kokilavan, there is a big Shanidev temple that you are seeing on the screen. And the Shanidev that you are seeing is on the road. Before you enter the temple, you will see this Shanidev deity. I mean, on the road. And then you will get entered inside. You will enter this temple. So then Krishna will, Yashoda Maya will get so scared. I don't know, because you're all born here. When I was as a little child also, if I was disturbed or if I was not well, my mom always used to say I have to do some Shani Puja for my daughter. So like that then, Krishna was saying that Yashoda Maya got so worried and Yashoda Maya took Krishna to Shanidev temple the next day and she did the Shani Puja. That's how Shanidev got the darshan of Krishna. So Krishna will do anything for his devotees. He's all expecting only that little bit of love. See, he lied though he was not scared. Though he lied for his devotees. And for Arjuna, what did he do? What did he do for Arjuna? He went as a
messenger.
He went as
he was feeding water
to the horses. He was brushing the horses. Why will he do? Will President Trump, who is now president now, is Joe Biden. So Biden, will he come and do all those things?
No.
If the president of one country is not doing them, then what to talk of president of the whole creation? So that is how he wanted to. He gave the darshan to Shanidev. He said a lie, and he changed. See, this is the Shanidev deity, and they worship him there. Okay. And
what did you stop sharing your screen?
I'm not sharing my screen.
No, Mataji, you're not sharing your screen.
Mataji, you are Mataji. You are.
Yes,
you
are Mataji. You're sharing your screen.
Okay, okay, okay. So next, you know, Krishna steals for his devotees. What is that pastime? How many of you know Kirch or Gopinath?
Mataji, I know Mataji.
I don't know.
You all know. So we will not discuss that pastime. We will not discuss that because most of you all know Krishna stole Kheer just for
his
devotee.
That's why he's called Kishore Gopinath.
Yeah, Kishore Gopinath. So he stole. And then he did all the planning for Kurukshetra war. Krishna, like how many of your parents would be IT. Yeah, Krishna did all the planning for Kurukshetra war. And when did Krishna change his gender?
Mohini Murti.
Krishna came as a girl to save his devotees. So Krishna will do anything. All he wants is just love. Okay, so we will discuss one pastime. Yes. So how many of you know this pastime?
No, okay.
We just have very less time. So let's discuss this pastime. So once there was one devotee called Raghudas, and he was a great devotee of Lord Sri Ram. And what happened to those who know? Please be quiet. And those who don't know, you can hear. Okay. So this Raghudas was a great devotee of Lord Sri Ram, and he would live at this Simhadwara in Puri. We know that there are different dwaras, right? So he would stay near Simhadwara, and whenever he looked at Lord Jagannath, he would see Lord Ram's face in Lord Jagannath. So then slowly he started getting so much attachment to Lord Jagannath, and one day he makes the garland from the threads of banana stems. If you see banana stem, there is like thread thing. So he made a garland with that, and he will bring to offer to Lord Jagannath. Because they have restrictions of what to offer, what not to offer. They said we cannot offer this. Then he was so disappointed, and he went back. And what happened from that next day, when the pujaris were trying to put garlands, you know, flower garlands, different flowers, Lord Jagannath was not even putting them on him. Once when they were trying to do it, they were falling down. When they were trying to fix them, they were falling down. He was doing that again and again. Then the pujaris were thinking, something is wrong. Why is this happening? It never happened. Why is this happening? And they started doing a lot of prayers, a lot of pujas, thinking that maybe something bad omen, maybe something bad is happening. And they were trying to do that pujas, all the different austerities. Then Lord Jagannath came in the dream of that pujari. And Lord Jagannath started saying that, you know, you please go get that garland from Raghudas. So immediately they went to Raghudas, and they asked him to bring that bark, that banana bark garland, and they offered it to Lord Jagannath. And Lord Jagannath was very, very happy. And one time, Raghudas was very, very sick for 15 days. Raghudas was such a nice devotee. You know what Lord Jagannath did? Lord Jagannath is none other than Krishna. We all know that, right? And what did he do? Raghudas was so sick. And one small boy was coming and cleaning him every day. There was a lot of smell. You know, when there is a sick person at home, I don't know how many of you have experienced when there is a sick person at home, that room actually smells a little bit different because of the medications, or they don't take bath. They are not in a position to take bath, and they do their toilet and everything on the bed. They actually, the room is not that pleasure for anybody to walk or pass by or stay. So then this Raghunath, he was so unconscious, and every day one small, Raghudas, every day one small boy was coming and he was cleaning him. After 15 days, he was realizing that who is this small boy? Every day is coming and cleaning me. I am just... So they was thinking, who is cleaning? Then finally, he understands that that was Lord Jagannath, and he will be starting. He will just cry and he will say, my Lord, why do you have to do this? Instead of doing this, you could have just, you know, just get me out of, you could have just cured me. But Lord Jagannath said, I'm so happy to serve my devotees. See, Lord Krishna can do anything if you have just love towards him. Krishna will do anything and everything for his devotees. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what did he do? Vasudeva Vipra, he was a leprosy person. And he wanted to have darshan of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he comes to see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he gets the news that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had already left. And Vasudeva Vipra will fall unconscious. He will feel very, very sad that he couldn't meet Lord. And Lord himself comes back and he will hug. Nobody hugs a leprosy person. He hugs him, he hugs Vasudeva Vipra, and Vasudeva Vipra was such a nice devotee. If any worms were feeding on the leprosy spots, if they fall down, he would keep them back again, saying that, okay, eat, feed on my blood. He would do that. Such a nice, compassionate devotee, he would do that. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was just seeing the devotee, that devotion, that love that he has towards Lord. He was not seeing any other material things like he has this, he has that, nothing. Now, because of Corona, we are so scared to meet anybody, touch anybody, give shake hand or give them a hug, or, you know, we're very scared. But Lord didn't mind all that. He just gave a hug to that leprosy, Vasudeva Vipra, and immediately Vasudeva Vipra gained a very beautiful body. That's another story. So what we are discussing is, like, how Lord is, you know, if you just show a little bit of love, that's what he all wants. He will do anything for us. Do you have any other examples? You have no examples? Anybody else has any example you can think of?
Mataji, I have a example.
What is that?
So when Krishna was coming to Mathura, So I forgot the lady's name, but she was a humpback.
Kubja, correct. Yeah, and even Dasya Mauri, again, this is a pastime from Jagannath Puri. Yeah, Dasya Mauri also. What does he do? He was longing to have darshan of Lord Jagannath, because he was from a very low caste. He was not allowed to enter inside. And how Lord Jagannath nicely reciprocates to him. So all these different pastimes, if we see, so many pastimes are there, you know, like he was saying about Kubja, and when Sanatan Goswami has a boil, still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu goes and he will touch him. So many
When Lord shows his form, there's also Mahaprakasha Lila.
Yes. So these pastimes, that's why now, that is the reason why he was not asking them to untie, because Krishna loves, you know, he just wants that love. That was the reason he's doing. He was not asking the boys to untie him. So now Krishna had an instruction from his mother, right? That he should not steal butter, but still he has been naughty. He's asking the friends to steal butter. He's still doing all those things, right? So how many of you will try to follow your parents' instructions?
Samshruti Mataji.
Chandra.
Mataji Kishan.
Yes, Ravachandra, you go ahead.
Mataji, I was saying that I try to follow my parents' instructions.
Mataji, your video paused.
Huh? Sorry. What did you say?
No, Mataji, I was saying my name because for the I try to follow my parents' instructions.
Oh, you try to follow? Is there anybody who is naughty like Krishna?
Yeah.
बलराम माता जी
बलराम
मुकुंद माता जी नॉट एज मच
आई नो मुकुंद इज अ वेरी गुड बॉय हु एल्स Oh, Krishnaina is saying like this, half and half. So, the point of our discussion today is Krishna is
looking... I just have one question about Vasudev Vipra before you go to the conclusion. So, why doesn't Vasudev Vipra feel pain? Like when he picks up the worms?
See, because they're not in bodily consciousness. See, sometimes when you're watching TV, suppose you have those who like TV to watch TV shows, when you're watching TV, what will happen? You're so much engrossed. I experience this with my son because he gets to watch in the weekend. When he's watching, he's like that. And when I do like this, when I call him, nothing. After 3-4 times only, he will turn and say, haha, what did you say? So if at least for a few seconds, he will not know what is happening. So imagine Vasudev Vipra, who is always thinking about the meditating on the holy names, you know, deeply engrossed. He doesn't even care all those things. He's not in a bodily platform. Many times we hear, right? We say we are not in bodily platform. We are not in bodily platform means that. What is that? They don't care. Like a Srila Prabhupada, what happened to Srila Prabhupada before he was leaving the body? Like he left this planet. He didn't eat for many days, and he was still doing the translation. He was still doing the transcriptions of Bhagavatam.
His devotees were only putting some drops every day, a few drops of Chandramrit.
That's what I'm saying. Then how could he do? Will you and me be able to do? One day you can stay 2 days, you can stay 3 days, okay, 4 days, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days. Will you do that? And when you're not, will we try to take rest? We don't do like Srila Prabhupada. Why did Srila Prabhupada do that? Because he is not bodily conscious. They're all at a different platform. If you ask me, how does that feel? That is not something like you can't see air. We can't see few things, right? So that we have to experience. So that also we have to experience. Like what all these great devotees, the great demigods who are great devotees of Krishna, what they're all experiencing. If we have to experience, then we have to do what they did. We can't say, I don't want to do, but I want to experience. That doesn't happen, right? If you want to, we have to follow their path, then we will also experience what that is. Okay, Suraj?
Mataji, can I say one story? Like a little story? It's like a little conversation. Like when you were saying like Prabhupada was like higher stage than us, there's one story, like there's a conversation with Prabhupada and this devotee, like a disciple, and Prabhupada, one disciple asked Prabhupada, who are you in the spiritual world? And Prabhupada says, if I tell you who I am in the spiritual world, then you'll be very astonished.
Yeah, that's true.
In the conversation, we can see Prabhupada is a very high person.
Yeah, correct. Correct. So that's Suraj, and all the Goswamis, like Raghunath Das Goswami, he just used to survive drinking 3 drops of buttermilk. Can we do that? Why they're doing? Because they're not in a bodily platform. So the main topic of our discussion today is why Krishna didn't want to be to didn't ask the boys to untie him.
We don't
want it because he felt the love of Mother Yashoda in that room. That is the main point of our discussion today. So Krishna is seeking only love from us. He doesn't mind how you look. He doesn't mind how you study. He doesn't mind what caste you are. He doesn't mind what is your background. He doesn't mind anything. Who's talking? He wants only our love. Okay. Do you all agree with that? Thumbs up or down?
Yes.
You all agree, right? Yes. So now we will just do a very small drawing because we discussed about rope of love. So can you all please draw like this in a paper? Very easy. Just 2 minutes, you can do it, right? And in the heart shape, please write Krishna. And on the rope, please write Yashoda. It's a small activity which you can do in 5 minutes.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Yeah, Mataji, while they are drawing, can we just announce about the Friday Bhagavad Gita recitation?
Yes, Mataji, please go ahead.
Yeah, kids, we will have the recitation on Friday, right? As yesterday we said. So every day, the teachers will be coming and telling you about the Friday recitation. And a detailed note is also coming in each and every WhatsApp group today. Okay, so we will have screenshots sent so that you can know exactly which verse you are reading. Okay, so Bhadra, Giridhari, Ojasvi, everyone who has registered, you will get your name against the verse. Okay, and see to it that you on the screen also we will have the verse posted. But if you have your Bhagavad Gita and if you want to read it from there, you can have that as well. And again, if you miss out your turn, now suppose whom should I give my name? Okay, I'll give my name. Suppose yeah. I'm going to read Bhagavad Gita chapter 1, verse 20. Okay, so by the time, and Balaram is reading the verse, chapter 1, suppose he's reading some verse and he's come up to the 15th verse. And Sita Priti Mataji is going to read from verse 20. I should be present before Balaram finishes. Okay, so I should be present rather when Balaram starts, I should be present so that we do not miss time. It will not look good, right, that we are reciting the Bhagavad Gita and there will be so many people calling out, oh, where is Mukund? Oh, where is Shri Krishna? Or where is Balaram? So instead of calling out, see to it that everyone is lined up properly. And when one finishes, the next one starts. When the next one finishes, the next one starts. Can we all do that? Can we all do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
Mataji. Yes, so we will be sending the screenshots for you all so that you can make a note of your verses. Because we wanted to accommodate all the kids at the end also who came. So there might be a little bit of shuffling of the verses. So you will, Virinda Mataji is showing, I guess, what verse, how the screenshots will be sent. See, the screenshots will be sent. So when you just pinch in, you can see which verse is by which person. Okay, from 1 to 55, there are 55 slots made for all the verses. Okay, so whoever choose which verse, and we have tried to have all. See, all the names are also given. Now, in the yellow, we have highlighted some names. Those kids are not very regular, so we do not know about them. If they are there, they can always recite. But I don't know how to contact these people. But all your names are given. So check for your name on your verse. Check for your name and your verse. And make it in your notebook. Just have it note down. Okay, that Shri is going to have from 12 to 22, chapter 2. Or Asura is having chapter 18, 68 to 78. And everybody is having at least 10 verses, okay? And according to the chapter and according to the number of verses, we have divided. So don't feel bad. Oh, she read 15 verses. I read 12 verses. It is not about the number. It is just a service that you're doing to the Bhagavad Gita recitation, okay? For Gita Jayanti. Anybody has any questions or anything, please post in the group or tell your parents also that, oh, my Bhagavad Gita recitation is there. I need to be on the call that day. And I want to see how you all are so responsible, right? That is the reason we have taken up this for the kids. Otherwise, it's only the adults who are doing it till last year. So let's make it a success.
Mataji, I have a question.
Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, is it Sanskrit shloka? Only recitation?
Only the shlokas. Only the shlokas, Mataji. Only shlokas.
Okay.
Only the shlokas, and one shloka read, the next one. Yes, Mukund?
I don't have a question about Deshav, but can Badmi Sakhi Mataji share the screen for the...
Yes, yes, she'll screen. Yes, Mataji, you can share.
Can you just tell the word that we have to write in the heart? I made this.
Badmi Sakhi Mataji?
Yes, Mataji, sharing.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hey, Bol.
Thank you, Sita Priti Mataji.
Hare Krishna. If anyone has any query related to the Friday, and it is at Friday, that is 25th of December, 4 p.m. CST. So just change the timing according to your time zone and be present, okay?
4 to 4, what was that? Can you please repeat timings?
4 p.m. CST.
4 p.m. Okay, Mataji.
Friday, 25th December, 4 p.m. CST.
Okay, Mataji.
Mataji,
question.
Yes, Mukund. Who is done? If somebody is done, please show. It's very simple. You all have to draw. It's not at all a difficult thing to wait and draw tomorrow.
Vinita Mataji, do you have anything to share more?
No, no, Mataji, you shared everything. Good, Mataji.
Okay, Mataji. Thank you, Padmasakhi Mataji.
Yeah, Govinda ke
Mataji, this is my drawing.
Mataji, can I take 1 minute, Vinita Gandharvika Mataji? Some kids might want to show.
Sure, sure, Mataji, take.
So, thank you. Who wants to show quickly?
Can Samskriti?
Balram, yes, Balram, go ahead.
I have a question, Mataji. My question is, Mataji, where did we rhyme? Yes, it was on the rope.
Yeah, in the, on the rope, you just try to, you know, draw a fat rope, little fat, and inside you can write Yashoda. Okay? Okay, Samskriti, where is Samskriti? See like how Samskriti did. Very good job. Very nice, Samskriti. Please post it in the group, okay? Mataji will upload on Facebook.
I'll color it first or whatever.
Okay, color it and upload. Is there anybody else
who wants to? Mataji, this is Kushi.
Kushi, where is Kushi? Kushi, very nice, Kushi. Very beautiful. Good job. I think we just have one more minute.
Mataji, or just we show?
Sure.
Mataji, can I show?
Who is that? I, Subhadra, right?
Yes.
Where is Subhadra? Wait, let me spotlight. Where are you? Can you take it a little bit back? Very nice, Subhadra. Who else?
Me.
Balram is done. Thank you, Subhadra. Wow, very nice, Balram. Look at that. How neat Balram drew.
Mataji, can I show?
Who is that? I, Varun? Oh, Krishna Naina. Show.
Krishna, time khatam hone wala. 1 minute mein band ho jayega.
Wow, very nice, Krishna Naina. You could have written Yashoda inside, no? She kept and she did creative. Very nice. Is there anybody else? Quick. Balram finished. Who is there? Mukund?
Thank you.
Almost done. Okay.
I just need to outline the ropes.
Okay. Ojasvi? Mukund, show. Mukund, show again. Look at Mukund's. Wow, look at how he wrote. Very nice, Mukund. Please send in the group, okay? So that anybody else can get benefited, right? If we post somebody, at least one kid can get benefit. Thank you. Thank you, Mukund. Very beautiful. Beautiful. I just loved it.
Thank you, Mataji.
This is mine, Mataji.
Very nice, Ojasvi. You're all tying Krishna so tight.
Ojasvi, your role is so perfect.
Yeah, that's what I... They're tying Krishna so tightly.
Thank you, Mataji.
By your beautiful drawing.
Mataji, Ramachandra is showing.
Where is Ramachandra? Mataji, can you spot? Spotlight. Take it a little bit back.
Oh, it's going on that. It's fine.
Yeah, very nice. Good job, Ramachandra. He always draws. You draw very nicely. Pratmesh.
Mataji, I thought...
Pratmesh finished. Very nice, Pratmesh. No, but that's fine. The paper doesn't matter. Very good. But don't forget to post in the group, okay?
Okay, Mataji.
If you can't post in the group, post it to me. At least I will post in the group. Okay. Is there anybody else or can we end the call? You all did a very good job. Sorry for the little disturbance there. I am not at my home today. So there are a lot of kids here. Little bit disturbance. I'm sorry for that.
That's okay.
Mataji. You know, Mataji, I hope you are saved, Mataji.
She's worried that you are traveling and you went to somebody's house. She's saying, I hope you are safe, Mataji.
Thank you, Rinda. Thank you so much. Yes, I'm safe because you are praying for me. Okay, so are we done? Then we can end the call.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, thank you also.
Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Jindaki Jai.
Good, very nice. Good, very nice. You can color it, book on color and send. Very nice.
Hari Bol.
Thank you all, kids. Thank you, Vinita Gandharvika, Mataji. Hare Krishna. See you all next week. Happy holidays.